Mimi was my type to a T when I first saw her. As I got to know her, like, there was more to just obviously the beauty, the depth, and that's when I feel like I've really got like hooked.
Welcome back to Kiss Fresh. It's Elle's with you until 7 p.m. and I am joined in the studio for the first time by some Love Island winners. It's Mimi and Josh. Hello.
Yo, what's going on?
Firstly, right, I know it's been a whirlwind. You've come out winners of Love Island. How is life treating you both?
Crazy.
Wow, wow, wow.
Yeah, overwhelming. Mm. I can't lie. To put into an example, I went to Bluewater and I had to leave within 20 minutes. It was that bad.
Really?
Crazy. Like, I never expected this kind of reception. I ain't complaining. I'm grateful. But yeah, it's hectic. But we're adapting pretty well, though, I'll say.
Mm. Yeah, it was a lot at first, trying to get your head around everything. Because for me especially, like, I just came from, like, 2,000 followers on Instagram to come back to this. It's mad. But I think we're getting there now. Getting more easier to like manage and like know how to navigate stuff.
Yeah, yeah, 100%.
The love has been real.
It's a learning process. It's only been a few weeks as well. So what was it like turning your phones back on for the first time? Was it just notification?
Because you just don't know what you're going to see.
Yeah.
But it was all right. I didn't pay attention to it too much.
A lot of love. So it was nice to come back to you. We were just speaking to our friends and family mostly when we got our phones back. So I asked my friends for the debrief before I entered the realm of the socials.
I'd have to do that because when you're in the villa, did you ever worry about what people would be saying on Twitter?
Oh, yeah, 100%. I did, 100%. Like, something would happen and in my head I'm like, I'm getting cooked on the show right now. Like, that's going to be in my head, yeah.
Literally.
Definitely.
I do think that then when I'm watching sometimes and there was particular scenarios, you know, like, obviously Joey was winding people up quite often. Do you reckon he ever thinks, people must be talking about me on the outside world?
I don't know, you know. I actually don't know. I don't know what goes through his head, to be honest. But, you know, whether he thought that or not, that's actually a good question.
And he's probably used to it because he's been on the TV scene for a while. Yeah. So something that he probably doesn't really think about firsthand. But, yeah.
Yeah, I think he's
used one of the OGs.
Yeah. Basically,
he's definitely used to it. Right, let's talk then all things Love Island. You guys actually won with 41% of the vote, which is crazy.
Mad.
And you broke history as well, first black couple to win Love Island.
Yeah.
How did it feel when Maya called out your names?
Surreal. It was crazy because we both weren't expecting it at all. Uh-huh. I feel like we were both just waiting to hear Kieran and Cole. So we were both like, I was smiling. Then she said us and I was like,
yeah, like, cause I think I've turned into a meme now because my reaction was like, what the hell?
Are you sure?
Yeah, I said it. I didn't expect to be in the finals, and then when we were in the finals, I didn't expect to win. If I'm being totally honest, it's the first time I said it, but I thought we was coming like maybe third, and second I was like, oh, we'll take second, like when it was two of us, and I was like, what, first? I was like, nah,
it was so weird. Even like when everyone was coming up to us, I was still processing everything. I was like, Wait, what?
Yeah, that was
is it really happening?
Yeah, it's mad, yeah.
But definitely. It's nice to know that we've like made history and like we keep saying, like it's nice to kind of like hopefully open doors for people like us to, you know, do what they want to do in the industry.
And inspire people, man, definitely. No matter what you're doing, you just always want to inspire people. Even before like doing this, like knowing that I've made someone want to do something was the best feeling.
Mm.
You know, people always talk about the prize money and stuff like that, but I feel like the real prize is knowing people might look at us and want to go and do something now. That's an unbeatable feeling.
Definitely. Yeah. And one thing I've seen so many people online talking about is that firstly, the right couple won, which I definitely agree with. But Josh, you came in and I think you might be my favourite male contestant ever because you just set such a good example of how a man should act. Do you know what I mean? Like you were so respectful of Mimi. You came and you only really had eyes for her the whole time. Yeah. And I just think that all the other guys should learn from how you came in. Because everyone comes in and talks about, oh, I needed a test.
Yeah.
Why did you need a test?
Mm, 100%. I just
think congrats to you both.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I mean, obviously, Mimi was my type to a T when I first saw her. And I feel like as I got to know her, like, there was more to just obviously the beauty, the depth. And that's when I feel like I really got, like, hooked. And I was like, nah, I don't really want to sort of risk this sort of thing. But yeah, it was that for me. I said it, her personality, how she is my favourite thing. So,
I love that.
And if he wanted to, he would.
I had the chance to. I really did have the chance to. And all the other girls are beautiful in their own way. Everyone's stunning. But I just felt like, nah, there wasn't really a need for me to risk it.
Exactly, I agree. If he wanted to, he would. You don't need a test. You should just, if you know, you know. If you know, you know. I want to talk about a thing that I saw on TikTok. So you were both on live. Don't know if it was TikTok Live, Instagram Live, you were on a live talking about a clip of Josh that went viral when you had short hair.
Oh my god. This ain't up a sign.
I'm going against all the odds. Are you going to cut the hair?
This is a question I'm being asked everywhere on all my social media platforms. Are you going to cut your hair? Keep your hair, cut your hair. me and Mimi are going to have a chat. And then we'll see. But for now, I think I'm rocking with the hair right now. Yeah, I'm rocking
the girlies love that TikTok.
Which one? The fade?
With the taper fade, isn't it?
A taper fade,
Yeah,
I'm undecided right now. So you might wake up one day and just see me with a fade, no hair. You just have to wait and see.
You're versatile.
Yeah, I'm versatile.
can rock them both. Right, we need to talk about one other thing.
Yeah.
So the other day it was the GRM gala and a few people from Love Island attended.
Yeah.
There's a photo and also a video circulating of Omar and Grace. So they were pictured together, like a proper full-on press shot. But then there was a video of them dancing together.
I haven't even seen that. I haven't seen that.
It's a very quick, they're in the background shot where it pans past them.
And what is it? They're just dancing together?
I think, they're dancing together, but TikTok are enjoying.
Oh, wow.
The prospect.
I haven't seen that. But it's strange because, I thought Grace and Ruben seemed fine. I didn't, did you?
I know that Grace and Omar were good friends. Mm-hmm. And it was left at that, so...
I don't know, it could just be a friendly dance. I never knew that.
It was probably just friendly.
Interesting. Right, well, it is time to spill the tea. Are you both ready?
Yep.
I have some questions just about things, you know, that I've seen online and rumors. So the first one is probably more directed towards Mimi. There was a lot of sharing of outfits in the villa, which people kept talking about online. Did people just not have enough options? There was one blue dress, which everyone kept talking about. The blue dress.
Oh my gosh.
Is that the one you want on a date?
It was near the end. The blue one that you said you look really nice in.
Oh, okay, that one.
Yeah. So that one was Matilda's dress. It went round because in the villa, it's hard. There's a thing called strobing where, like, you can't wear certain things because it affects the camera. So that, like, cancelled out most of our outfits. So it came to it that we just have to show outfits and...
The blue dress was it.
Like, and Matilda was a class babe for that because she'd let us wear her outfits before she even got to wear them. But yeah, it was hell out there.
That is a real good friend, actually.
Seriously.
Letting your friends wear something before you've even worn it.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
It's a good friend.
Real G.
Shout out to Matilda.
Shout out to Matilda. The next one I saw was... And this, I don't know why this always becomes a thing online, but everyone wants to know about people vaping in the villa. And there was one clip, and I can't remember where it is, but there was apparently queues for the vapes in the villa. Mm-hmm. So what was that about? Was there just like a certain amount of time where people could vape or?
I think it was just like, there was only one person out there at a time for anything like that. So the vaping, cigarettes, snus, all of that, one person at a time to go out because... They wouldn't want everyone in the group because there might be like some drama or something.
Oh, when people were...
People are out there. So yeah, there was a queue one by one.
Yeah, definitely.
Interesting. Okay, next one is... We kind of touched on this earlier, but I just wanted to talk about Joey because I find him fascinating because half the time I couldn't figure out if... Because he's such a seasoned veteran in reality TV, if he knew just how to press people's buttons or he knew how to sort of create drama. Was he genuinely like that or do you think he was sort of playing up to the cameras a bit?
It's crazy because at the start, me and Joey were like really, really good. We got on really, really well. What as well was the fact that we're two big characters, personalities, me and him. So it caused us to clash a lot. It was like no one was like giving leeway. I don't know, because I don't know what he's like on the outside. So it's very hard to tell. I didn't know him before. I met him in there. So only someone close to him could probably answer that. So I'm not sure.
We'll just have to keep guessing.
All
right, well, that's all we have time for. Thank you so much, Mimi and Josh, for joining me. I cannot wait to see what you guys get up to next.
Yeah, watch your space.
Keep watching. All right, thank you so much. And we'll see you guys soon.
Thank you.